Do you know that you can interact with maps charts in Data Studio just like in Google Maps app? Actually, we can do more than that. In this video, we will talk about 3 ways to zoom in Google Maps chart. By default, to zoom in to specific area, you could tap on the plus sign on the map located on the bottom right of the map visual. Alternatively, you could double-click on the map to zoom in closer to a specific area. This is very similar to Google Maps user interface. However, the default setting is not user-friendly and very time-consuming, especially when we have a larger range of data that's scattered on the map. It can take a while to identify an area and zoom in to a lower level. For instance, London in UK. That leads us to the second option, which is by using a filter control to enable user to zoom in to a specific country or city with just one click. Let's say I've traveled to Subang Jaya and I want to have some nice food there in my selected restaurant outlets. I can click on this filter branch and select Subang Jaya. Then the map would automatically zoom into that region. This helps to improve user experience with the Google Map charts, so they no longer need to pan around or click on the map to see more granular location data. Just some additional note here, this method will require us to have a dataset that has a higher level of location data. In my case, it's the branch field. And also, the fields for filter control not necessarily need to be in draw type. It can be in string data type. So next, I'll show you how you can set this up. To build that, we can add a control and select drop-down list. Click on the van canvas to add the filter, and then go to the property panel and look for branch, drag and drop into control field. And then when we switch to view, we can now select a region from the filter. Let's say we're going to choose Subang Jaya. Click only. And now the map is zoomed into the specific area. So in this example, we actually allow users to zoom in and out of the map using a simple filter control. But there are some cases where we want to limit to specific region without allowing users to have visibility or control over. So in this case, you could add the filter in the chart directly. For illustration purpose, we are going to limit the view of the dashboard to exclude Penang outlets. So now navigate to resource and click on manage filters. I already have one here, but just for demonstration purpose, I'm going to create a new one. Click on the add a filter. Let's name this filter as exclude Penang. Here, I'm going to choose exclude. I'm going to use address contains Penang. So I'm going to exclude where I found that address contains the word Penang. After we have done with that, click save. Now at the property panel under the filter, click add a filter and select exclude Penang 2. Now we can see that the map is automatically zoomed in to Klang Valley region, because now we have excluded Penang from the dataset. So in summary, today we have learned 3 methods on how we can zoom in or out from the Google Maps. It just takes a few additional steps to make the most out of Google Maps chart in Data Studio. In case you missed last week's tutorial where we talk about how you can plot a bubble map using latitude and longitude data in Data Studio, I'll put the link up here so that you can watch it after this. So as usual, I have a more detailed write-up in my website, theanalyzer.com, where I have included some of the points that I didn't mention in this video, including the comparison of zoom area in draw charts and Google Maps in Data Studio. So if you are interested to read on that to find out more, feel free to do so. And if you wish to support me in this journey of sharing Data Studio tutorials, do subscribe and like this video. You could also buy me a coffee at coffee.com, which I'll put the link below as well. And thank you for being part of the journey. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.